that's not able to make it today. So if you see Kellen sometime later this week, be sure to tell him happy birthday. All right, well, thanks anyway, Connor. Good. We're so glad you're here tonight. I hope you all got a bulletin with a communication card. And if you could fill out that communication card with your name and contact information on the back, there's boxes you can check if you want more information. Also, you can write down a prayer concern here. If there's something you want the church to be praying for in your family or in your life, that's a great place. We really want to support you with a gift of prayer. Every single week, we have Bibles available. If you don't have a Bible at home, please take one of the blue Bibles down from your pews. And take that home with you so you can read and use it. And I really want to invite you, in just a minute, I'm going to invite all of you to stand up and find something you haven't met yet. And we have a saying around here. Sometimes we say, God loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Try it. So I want you to find three people, shake your hand and give them a high five and tell them, God loves you and there's nothing you can do about it. And while you're doing that, as best you want, you group, are you hearing me? Wait, not yet. Not yet. 3 seconds. Wait. I have more stretches. When you do that, I want you so we're all together in one big group. So, especially you, if you hear that, what do you do? Find three people and a person that you go now.
Group. ate Twinkies in the park with God. She's much younger than I expected.
Did you notice a difference in the woman after she talked to the boy? Raise your hand if you saw something different about the woman. What did you see, Bryn? She was much happier, wasn't she? And what does the woman say to her friend when she meets her? What did you hear her say? Younger than she expected, right? No, she said, I ate Twinkies in the park with God, and it was a lot younger than I expected. I really liked this video because, of course, we're not God, are we? But did you know every single one of us is called to be God's ambassador? And you have an important opportunity every day of your life to share God's love and God's goodness just by showing up and making the most of every moment. You might not know whose life you can even touch and change because you decided to share what you have, to smile together, and to laugh together. So I want to encourage you to keep thinking about that. And I hope your eyes will be open to the ways in which others are extending God's love and goodness to you, and the ways you can share God's love with others as well. And maybe we need to open our eyes a little wider and see the ways that we can bring God's love into the world and to see the ways God might be showing up to the people around us. So I want you to think about that and pray about that as Beth leads us in our opening song tonight.
Thank you.
Jesus. Open the eyes of our hearts. We want to see you. Help us to listen for you. Help us to look for you. And teach us so that we can live for you. Amen. Well, last week we talked about a guy named Peter, and you remember after Jesus rose from the dead, he went to Peter and he gave Peter a brand new name, Peter, instead of Simon. And who remembers what Peter means? Does anybody remember what that means? Tanner in the balcony remembers?
Rock.
Foundation.
Yeah, rock.
Rock. He said, Peter, you're going to be the foundation, the rock that I'm going to build my church on. And he and John went out teaching and sharing the good news. And do you remember last week, who did they encounter who needed God's love and God's help? What was wrong with that, the man that they met? Do you remember? What was wrong with the nickel? He couldn't walk. He was paralyzed. And then what happened when Peter and John encountered him? Who remembers? What happened, Cole? They healed him so he could walk. And they shared with him good news about Jesus Christ. Well, today we're going to talk a little bit more about Peter's story, and we're going to get into the time machine. Anybody like getting into a time machine? We're going to go back in history a little further, because before Peter and John were teaching about Jesus, before Jesus rose from the dead, before he was crucified, there's a story about Peter and Jesus. Because Peter is talking to Jesus. Jesus knows he's going to die. And Jesus says to Peter, Peter, you are going to not deny that you know me three times. Can you guess what Peter said to that? Maybe some of you remember that story. Does anybody know what Peter said in response? What would you say if a friend said, hey, you're going to pretend you don't even know me three times, what would you say? No way. It's not going to happen. He said, Jesus, I love you. It's never going to happen. But Jesus was arrested, and he was thrown in prison, and eventually he was crucified. And so Peter began to be very afraid about if he would get arrested too, or even if he would be hurt for following Jesus. So, guess what? Three times people come to Peter and they say, hey, weren't you with that Jesus guy? And Peter's so afraid. Do you know what he said? Can you guess? He said, I don't know him. I wasn't with him. So we're going to watch a movie now that talks about what might have happened between Jesus and Peter right away in the beginning. The first time Peter sees Jesus after the resurrection. This is so important, especially because I wonder how many of you are here in this room, have you ever made a mistake that hurts a friend or someone in your family? Have you ever done that? I've done that too. And so this is an important movie when we think about sometimes the mistakes we make that hurt each other and what God thinks about it. So check this out. Oh, first
we grace is God's unmerited favor for us, his crazy love. And the truth is, many times we struggle understanding it. If you find yourself struggling to understand God's grace, don't beat yourself up. Even the disciples struggle with understanding grace.
Jesus sent you? You're alive! I can't believe you're alive! Okay, I was in the boat, and I wasn't catching any fish, okay? But I heard this voice, and the voice said, cast your net to the other side. And so I'm thinking, I'm a fisherman, I'm good, but I'm not catching any fish, you know? And so I throw that net over there, and then I'm gagging the fish up into that net, and I'm going, this is a total miracle. Who could have done that? I need to know who told me to throw the net to the other side. And boom, I look up, and I mean, there's you. You're looking at me on the seashore, going, it is I, the Lord.
Peter.
Yeah. Do you love me? Yes, I love you. I love you. You're alive. This is so great.
Hey, you can feed my sheep.
Andrew, get out of the boat. Come on, man. It's him.
Peter.
Yeah.
Do you love me?
I love you. Yes. And I'm so sorry about that rooster clucking. I had no idea what that meant, but I do not live far. All right. Okay.
Then feed my sheep.
Andrew, I'm smiling, but I'm get out of the boat, Tim!
Peter.
Yeah.
Do you love me?
Jesus. Mere words cannot describe the passion that I have for you. I love you. You know everything. I love you.
Good. Good. Then feed my sheep.
I need my livestock. That is so like you. There's something new about you all the time. That's what I love about you.
Peter, do you remember the morning the ladies went to the tomb?
Yeah. We're all in the room trying to figure out what to do next, you know, because we thought you were dead. You know, you were dead, you know. We're trying to figure all that out, you know. And Mary comes running up, and Mary's like saying, beehive, beehive, beehive. And I'm thinking, I'm allergic to bees. I keep them out, you know what I'm saying? But as she kept getting closer, I heard her correctly. She was saying, he's alive, he's alive, he's alive. And I'm going, who's alive, who's alive? And she said, she was at the tomb, and the tomb was empty. And she said that there was an angel there. And the angel said, go tell the disciples and Peter that everything is okay, he's risen. And so me and John, we hightail it down there. And if John says he beat me, he's totally lying, all right? I beat him, FYI, all right, you know? And we get down there, and I'm looking at that tomb, and there it is. It is empty. There's nothing in there, you know what I'm saying? And I'm like, what does this mean? What does this mean? And John is right there.
John is so good at words. He should write a book. He is so good at words. And John said, don't you get it, Peter? This is everything Jesus said he was going to do. And you did it. It's done. Let's go. This is so great.
Wait, the angel said what?
Go tell the disciples and Peter that everything is okay. He is risen. You've risen. Let's go.
He said what?
Go tell the disciples and Peter.
The same number that Peter had denied him. Jesus wanted Peter to know that they were really right with each other. And Jesus also wanted Peter to know what was really important to Jesus. You know, Jesus says, then feed my sheep. But a lot of times, you remember we talked about this earlier this winter, all of God's people are sometimes called sheep, right? Do you remember when we talked about Jesus, the Good Shepherd? So Jesus is really asking Peter, will you go and share with others the good news? Will you feed them? If they're hungry, give them food. And if they're hurting on the inside, give them help. And if you see them and they're sick or need help, bring them healing. Jesus was asking him, will you share the good news? So I wonder if right now there's anybody in this room who is feeling bad because maybe they hurt somebody they love and care about. Or I wonder if you feel like maybe God is disappointed in you because you made some mistakes in your life. I want you to know God's forgiveness is available. All you have to do is ask. God is so ready to give you a second chance, a third chance, a fourth chance, as many chances as you need. And God still asks a powerful calling on your life. Will you be part of something bigger than yourself? Will you be willing not only to accept God's love and forgiveness, but then to share it with others? So I want you to bow your heads and say a prayer with me right now. Dear Jesus, we make mistakes all the time. Lord, we ask that you would help us because we have hurt other people. We ask that you would forgive us of our mistakes and our sins, and that you would help us to live better and to share your love with those who need it the most. Use us, Lord, we pray. Amen. We'll invite Beth as she leads us in song tonight. We'll also take our offerings and receive our communication cards at this time.
Don't you know that's not your name?
today, I want you to hold out your hand, and we're going to pray for a few people and write just the first initial of their name. And we're going to start with a B for Beth. Let's pray for Beth and write her initial in the palm of our hand. And then let's lift our hand up to God, knowing that God will be with her and help her with her talk. We also want to pray, many of you know Dwayne and Meva. Dwayne has been here every Wednesday night teaching class with Meva. And Dwayne is not able to be here tonight because of his health. And so let's write a D on our hand for Dwayne. Let's pray for Dwayne. And lift that up to God. I know you might have some prayer requests too, and I'd like you to talk in your family groups about who you're praying for in your family. Share with your mom and dad. And as you come up with names of people you're praying for, you can write them in the palm of your hands also. And leave them up to God to pray for them. Church mission statement. Can you please stand and let's say it together, shall we?